All right, let's talk about the big doings going on up in Evanston. It's been something that's been percolating for the last couple of months. Today, a possible landmark vote. The guys, 76 eligible players, casting a vote as to whether or not to unionize. Now, we will not know whether or not what the results of the balloting is because it's a secret, but this is something that happened at Northwestern today. We're told that every single one of the 76 eligible players participated in the voting this morning. This is something that they believe passionate about. We don't know why they voted, but this is an important day in college football history. Let's go to Lisa Byington, who has a report from Evanston. Lisa Byington, take it away.
All right, thank you. With Alan Cubbage, who is a university spokesperson, and we live in a society where people want answers now. What kind of timetable has the NLRB given you?
Unfortunately, we don't have any timetable at all. The university learned yesterday that the national board is going to review the decision by the Chicago regional director, but there's no timetable at all for how long it takes them to make a decision.
The university has made the stance that they believe students are students and not employees. Why?
Well, we feel very strongly that the main purpose of the football players being at Northwestern University is academics. You know, that our students are first and foremost students. They are not employees. And that's been our position consistently, and I assure you, we believe that strongly.
Some people have questioned the way the university has reached out to the student-athletes, even to the student-athletes' parents throughout this whole process to educate them. How do you answer some of those questions?
What the university has done during this election campaign is to communicate clearly to as many people as we can the university's position and why we feel that unionization and collective bargaining are not appropriate. And obviously we've communicated directly with the players, we've communicated with the players' parents, and we've communicated with other audiences, including the media, obviously.
What are the positives for Northwestern coming out of this?
Oh, I actually do think there's some benefit in this for Northwestern. One of the things, for example, is we have been able to get a lot of people to know that we have a 97% graduation rate among our football team. You know, that's been something we've been very proud of, but at the same time, that's the sort of news that normally doesn't make national news. Now it's made national news. I think Northwestern has honestly, you know, come across as an institution that cares about its student athletes, that cares about its students, and, you know, has done a great job. I mean, you know, I realize I may sound overly optimistic, but, you know, it's been a challenging discussion. There's no doubt about that. These are big national issues. But I also think the spotlight on Northwestern has allowed us to show what a great place this is.
Alan Cubbage, we appreciate the time, and now it's just the waiting game. Back to Chicago.
Lisa, thank you so much. Howard Griffith, you played in this great conference. You coached in this great conference. Your thoughts on what we're seeing today?
Well, a couple comments off what we just watched. I disagree with Mr. Cubbage. I don't think there's any upside to Northwestern. The second thing is you notice all the players dressed in the same outfit as they went to vote. And I believe that's intentional. I believe the majority of the team will vote no. The union will never come to pass. And when you talk about the judges, here's what I predict is going to happen. The team voted no today not to have a union. Then it goes to the Washington, D.C. judges. They're going to support the Chicago judge. And then when they count the ballots, Howard, I see the union not being voted in. Mm-hmm. The problem with Northwestern at that point is that the football players at Northwestern are going to be the only student athletes in this country that are considered employees of a university by virtue of them playing a sport. Mm-hmm. And so we don't know where that's going. So there could be a minority opinion in that locker room that still has more influence over what happens to the Northwestern football players than anybody else, because if the vote is no, they are still employees without a union. And I think that's a major problem for Northwestern.
Well, I think one of the other things that's key, Eric, really, that they have to pay attention to as well is the locker room itself. You just alluded to some of the minority that may have said, yes, we don't know that, we won't know that, but say they're leaders of the team. Those things are going to come out at some point. Guys are going to be talking around, sitting around discussing the vote today, and they may talk to one another and say, well, I voted this way, I voted that way. But if you have some guys in there that are the leaders of the team that say that, you know, guys, I think we should have gone the other way, we should have been voting yes, that's going to cause a divide. So I think one of the things that Pat Fitzgerald has to continue to do is do the best job he can of keeping the team together, because his job is to win football games. That's why Pat Fitzgerald is there, to win football games and help these guys graduate and get an opportunity to get be productive in society.
I guess my question to you guys is the overwhelming majority of people believe that this is going to be voted down, that the players don't want this. If you're a 17 to 22-year-old kid, why would you say no to this? You've got a chance to collectively bargain for better hours, for possible better health insurance long term. Why is this not attractive to these Northwestern players, in your opinion?
Well, because that's not the issue. It's not an issue of what's attractive to the players and what's not attractive to the players. I think we all want better health care. Jim Delaney last summer proposed a lifetime scholarship. No one's against the cost of education. No one's against the stipend. That doesn't mean that you have to be an employee of the university. The other thing is, Fitz has been criticized, and the university has been criticized for spreading information or for sharing their side. I don't understand why Kane Coulter gets to take the gloves off, why Kane Coulter gets to play big boy football, and he can be critical of everybody else, but the university can't respond to it. And so if he wants to get in big boy arguments, this is what a big boy argument's all about.
And I'll say one other thing. When you talk about why those 17-year-olds don't want to get involved in or see this as an opportunity to really advance, because it's not going to be for them, ultimately. It'll be for some of the classes that come after them. Because it's exactly that. They're 17 and 18-year-olds trying to get onto the field, trying to get a degree. And like a lot of people, I won't say most, but a lot of people, they don't want any parts of this. When you go back when this first started, and Pat came out and said he was really supportive of his team, the showed leadership and that sort of thing, and a lot of guys signed that initial petition. Quite a few guys signed it. And then you saw guys back away. Well, wait a minute. And they started to back away because adults and lawyers got involved. And the way it was painted, it was Kane Coulter versus Pat Fitzgerald in Northwestern University.
Yeah, and I find that interesting too. All of a sudden, guys are saying, we didn't know what we were signing. I thought these were the brightest and the best. You ought to know what you're signing. And the other thing about this, Eric, unions have started in this country not because of money, but because of mistreatment. And to buy into this means that most of the college athletes, whether on Northwestern's team or around the country, feel like they're being mistreated. I am so contrary to that. My personal experience has just been the opposite. I went to a school I couldn't have been admitted to if I didn't play football. I had a great experience. My parents couldn't afford it to send me to Notre Dame. I had an experience only through football. And so most of the players in the country feel the way I just described. We're listening to a few. Kane Coulter had a bad experience at Northwestern, and that's the origin of this.